Build a snowman and build him up.
Hello guys, my name is Russian Badger, and I'm quite proud of myself because I just named all 8 of Santa's reindeer, not including Rudolph, of course, who is the 9th inclusion, off the top of my head without thinking about them for like 12 months. And in case you live in a country that is yet to embrace the joys of capitalism, allow me to fill you in, because they include Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, Tyrone, Blitzen, 2 Chainz, and of course, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, who's more of a criminal than you might think. And I'm not even kidding at all when I say that Rudolph is a straight thug because of his weapon expertise. And in case you haven't seen him fire his pistol, every shot is like a fadeaway no-look J-ball from Dwight Howard. Just look at him and the way he fires.
Damn, it feels good to be a gangster. A real gangster.
Now, in addition to Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, who runs the support kit in this Christmas CTE theme, there is also Santa Claus, who runs the assault class, Frosty the Snowman, who plays the engineer, and of course, the recon class, which features a shady-looking elf that gives off an extremely rapey vibe. Just look at him! I bet if he stumbled across a corpse made of sandpaper, he'd still go for it. Now, the first thing that I noticed upon joining a server in CTE with his Christmas theme is how the entire server is much more in the holiday spirit compared to regular vanilla servers. I mean, just take an example. Here's the holiday spirit in CTE. And here's a lack of holiday spirit in vanilla. This is holiday spirit. This is not holiday spirit. And of course, this new theme provided me the opportunity to stab Santa Claus with an icicle, and there was no way that I would be denied that opportunity. You know, watching that back now on video really doesn't capture how it felt. I mean, it seemed much more exhilarating at the time when that actually happened in game. I don't know. I guess I could just hype it up a little bit more and add a little flair or glamour or something.
Legalize crystal fucking weed.
I guess the real shame about this theme is that CTE really doesn't stand for community test environment. It really stands for competitive tryhard environment, which means that everyone is playing assault, which of course means that the entire map is pretty much full of Santa Claus killing other Santa Clauses, and it's really confusing. And I'm not gonna say that killing Santa Claus or Saint Nikolaus Iceberg isn't interesting, but it gets a little weird when he never wipes that morbid smirk off of his face. And in case you guys were in an Easter egg mood, there is a new one that I found where if you kill Frosty the Snowman with a single Desert Eagle shot to the dome piece after jumping out of a jet, he'll quietly whisper a secret in your ear if you get close enough. Closer. Closer. I'm in love with the coco. And I must admit, for some reason, the over-the-top head models do make the game much more enjoyable. I don't know if it's because it takes away from the seriousness, or it's just silly enough to entertain me, but as soon as I saw these characters, it immediately reminded me of a game that's like, it's gotta be at least 10 years old, which is called NHL Hits.
Stick save, Lindstrom controlling the puck.
Huge hit by Galahad! Gunner shoots the puck! A stop! Gump! They put it in! Galahad gets the first goal of the game!
It was an old hockey game that I played on PS2 where you could literally play as an alien, a Spartan, a zombie, or even a shark if you wanted to.
Galahad! Gunner! Dragon!
And it got me thinking that these are the types of things that EA and DICE should be distributing in battle packs, not 25% XP boosts. Now, I know you would need proper execution of such a feature, making it purely cosmetic and not changing the hitbox, but I think it's something that I would love to have instead of more and more weapon skins. For example, I'd rather have a dinosaur head and look like a velociraptor running around and jumping on top of people's necks than have 500 different variations of desert camouflage on my AK. Like, who cares? And again, I have to say that if you have never played NHL Hits and you have no idea what I'm talking about, you missed out. You unequivocally missed out, because it was incredible.
What a bone-crushing hit that was! Hands and out of play. Boom, baby! Ding dong! He just runs into a brick wall. Hit me, baby, one more time. Isaac is controlling the puck. They score! Gunner gets the go-ahead goal!
And just for the record, I'm pretty sure Frosty the Snowman is my favorite character model, especially when he's holding rocket launchers. He seems so American. He seems like he loves democracy and capitalism with the subtraction of derivatives, but whatever. I mean, just look at this guy when he's holding these types of weapons. America, fuck yeah, coming again to save the motherfucking day, yeah, America. We got a man down. Now, in terms of the small ammo pack, I didn't get the reference of this crying penguin. I mean, I know what the crying seal is all about. And I know the penguins from Madagascar are pretty funny.
I did it!
But I didn't quite get this reference. I don't know, maybe I'm not Swedish enough, maybe I didn't take physics at the right university, or maybe this is some kind of L'Epic Maymay reference that I will just never understand because I'm not from Europe. And one final thing, you guys need to stop teasing me in servers about being a bad pilot, because it's severely hurting my self-esteem and my internet ego. It really is bruising it. And it's not like I can't fly because I'm a poor player. I can't fly because
I cannot see, I'm legally blind.